Two steps to better search results. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. If you spend any time on askleo.com, you'll notice that one of the things I suggest you do often is search for the answer you're looking for. I actually, when you go to ask me a question, I re-emphasize that a lot because very often the answers that I end up providing are answers that are already on the website. Rather than waiting for me, a couple of additional searches, for example, could get you the answer you're looking for right then and there. That's true for search in general, not just on Ask Leo. And what I want to do is I want to show you a couple of things that over the years I've learned about how people search and a couple of mistakes that they make and my preferred approach to searching when you know more or less what it is you want to search for. So let's flip over to Google real quick, and I'll show you a couple of the issues that I run into. So here we are at google.com. The same actually applies for almost every search engine. I'm just going to use Google because most of you do. The first mistake that I see people doing frequently, I mean, I see this a lot when I take a look through my own search logs and when I watch other people search, is they will type in a sentence, sometimes a paragraph, into the search bar. So for example, here on Google, if I'm going to, I've got this long question, I can't get on my computer, I bought it from a garage sale, it's got an administrator password, yada, 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 right? It's this huge, long thing. It's gotten better. As we'll see in a moment, it's actually gotten much better. But this is something to be avoided. Focus on the terms you care about. Because what you don't know is how Google or any search engine is going to interpret your sentence. There were many keywords in that sentence that I just typed. Google could trigger on any of them. Now, in this case, like I said, it got better. Google's actually returning relevant results to what the question is probably asking, but this is in no way guaranteed. Very often, lengthy questions, lengthy sentences and paragraphs of information typed into your search bar will get you lots of misleading results. The other problem I see frequently is giving up. Take a look again at the search results we've got here. Let's assume for a moment Google misinterpreted the question and gave me results for something else. There are 21 million results for this question. Chances are that even if Google did a bad job of interpreting what I was looking for, something close to what I was looking for would show up on subsequent search pages. That's why this exists down here. I'm not suggesting that you need to go through all 21 million results. What I am suggesting is that if you're not finding what you're looking for on the first page, go to the second. Go to the third. Spend a little bit of time understanding two things. One, whether or not your question has been answered somewhere in these top two, three, four pages of results. Or, based on what you see, take a look at how Google has misinterpreted your question. Because that way, you can learn to rephrase your question in a way that will be more on point. So if those are the things not to do, what are the things to do? Here's my two-step process. Step one, start simple. Choose a couple of keywords that are highly relevant to whatever it is you're looking for. So let's say that you are in fact looking for how to get into a computer that has an administrator password that you don't know. The very first thing I would try searching for would in fact be administrator password. And even though I've mistyped it, you can see that Google got it right. It's looking for administrator password. Now, you may get close right then and there. In fact, you may find the answer you're looking for with just those keywords. Let's assume not. Let's assume for a moment that there's stuff here that's close, but not quite. It has lots to do with the administrator password, but nothing to do with what you specifically want. Great, this is where we refine. This time I might say Windows 10, because I might see that it's a Windows 10 machine that I've received from an auction or yard sale or whatever. Now, if I take a look at the results, I may find something that is more appropriate to the actual problem that I'm looking at. This is an iterative process. I call it a two-step process, but honestly, it's a multiple-step process. Because each time you search, you will get results. And as you can see, each time you search, Google will make some suggestions about things that other people have been searching for. Pay attention to those. But each time you search, you will get a set of results that will either be close or far away from what it is you're looking for. Take the time to think about what other keywords should be added to get your search closer, or what keywords maybe are distracting. Maybe it's not a Windows machine at all. Maybe it's not a Windows 10 machine. So take the 10 away, add 11. You get the idea. The point here is that to spend a little bit of time experimenting with the phrases you use, the keywords you use when you are searching. Those two steps, starting simple and then refining, are going to get you many more on-target answers than waiting for someone else to answer and understand your question. I hope that's helpful. I hope that gives you a little bit of a direction next time you're searching for things. It applies to Google. It applies to Bing. It applies to on-site searches like Ask Leo's search. Give it a try. For updates, for comments, for related links and more, visit askleo.com/16909. I'm Leo Notenboom. This is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.